calling out this guy a couple of fucking weeks, I have.
Coming up next is the UFC heavyweight
I don't know
division
why.
Collision.
Dumbest move of my life. Calling up fucking Francis. Especially after getting knocked out. May that explode, cunt. Come at me.
Alright, so after a loss by knockout his last time out, we'll see if this young man can regain the momentum that saw him vault into contention not all that long ago. His corner man really believes that this adversity could be something that buoys him going forward. Certainly nobody wants to be knocked out and in devastating fashion the way he was in his last fight. But now tonight, another opportunity to prove that he is one of the best in the world in this division. Well, you see him land the jab there. He's got the reach advantage. You might as well use it. All right, here we go with round one. Prevailing wisdom is he's going to try to set up a takedown here early and ultimately get to some of those ground strikes.
Get him, get him.
Right away, this guy knows exactly what he is at his core, and he uses it as effectively as anyone who's seen in the octagon.
Fucking if you're going to let me have a freebie. Freebie, I'll take it, cunt.
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up.
Cunt, if you're going to let me have fucking freebies, I'm going to take it.
Very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. If Gano gets caught with that punch, he'd be wise to get those hands up. Already closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
Cunt.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the gentleman. Oh, nice.
Oh, vicious uppercut.
Oh.
Whoa! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
I think he's cut open. Yeah, that's definitely not my blood. Francis, if you're going to give me freebies, I'm going to fucking take advantage of that shit, cunt.
Alright, so he postures up here and now figures to rain.
Body strikes aren't as good this game.
Be a plenty from this position.
Straight right hand now, just
what
a punch.
Alright, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quickly.
I mean, just right away, blasting the jab after jab after jab. He is a phenomenal
fucking
boxer.
Back up.
Whoa! It's over.
Fucking.
Oh my goodness! What a fight!
Yeah, man, crowd loving it. Just a gorgeous.
Wow,
shot.
What do you expect,
it's
Francis? Fucking one shot me, you cunt.
The utmost extent. Nicely done.
The cunt one shot me.
Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of it. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official.
He did normal, Francis. What do you expect? I was talking shit. Talk shit and get hit.
Well, there will be no shutting that smile off. Celebration is on as he gets a huge win by knockout tonight. I gotta think there are.
I'm gonna fucking beat the next one, cunt.
Walking into an octagon and candidly knocking another man out.
Yeah, you said it.
I'll knock him out next time. Fucking Derek Lewis number 2. Hopefully I can win this one again. Fucking on 2-fight loss. If I fucking lose. Oh, it's gonna fuck me. Fuck me.
Coming up next is the UFC heavyweight showdown.
Alright. Coming, Lewis. Herb. Alright, let's go, mate.
So he lost his last fight by devastating knockout. So the question beckons as round one gets underway here. Can he regain the momentum that saw him vault into contention not all that long? The ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way. The referee's going
to
stop
him. He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away,
fuck. Worst, mate, I don't appreciate that. He cannot allow him on that angle.
Attack an arm bar. Nicely done. He gets the elbow up into the target. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch.
All right, fucking jiu-jitsu god. Fucking Derek Lewis, apparently. Fuck off.
Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound.
The repetitive launch is a bit annoying. Fuck me, cunt.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Oh, fuck off. Fucking, I hate my fucking life with this shit.
I mean, how many can he take?
Oh, fuck off, you cocksucker.
The ground and pound is there. Just over
3 minutes
to go.
Try to fucking fake out there.
Alright, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top,
what the fuck
fighting,
happened?
He feels like he's winning here.
Oh man, this ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is the opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
Good.
So we call on the numbers here, DC. 55 total strikes have landed for the Black Beast, Derek Lewis. Unable to connect there. 2 minutes now to go in the round. Punches blocked. Changes his stance.
Straight right. Fuck me, cunt.
Lands with the kick there. No pad on that foot.
No shin guard. He's taking all of that kick. Every time he throws it.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Ooh.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Oh, he got that knee up to the head. Hard shot. Oh, big knee.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! Oh, he might be out. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
Well, he continues to stay busy and he continues to land with volume punches here.
Back up. There you go.
And just like that, the fight is over.
He got him. What a fight.
Fucking took him out, what, same as last time.
Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. So he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the number. Now we go
yeah,
that
was a nice knockout.
With the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop.
Nice little turn on his fucking forehead.
7 seconds of the very first round. Playing the winner.
Alright, we're back on our old winning ways. We'll take that. We will take it. Fucking, who's the next fight? That's all I want to know. Like, guess we'll just have to see. Curtis Blades. Chuck Liddell, fucking Rampage. Fucking Henry TJ. Curtis Reed. See if I can get in top five off this fight.
Gets to the ground. Blades is attempting to pass here, but he's denied by the defense. And they both stand up. Working out of that southpaw stance. Oh, look at that jab. Snaps his head back. And he gets the takedown.
Gets the takedown and falls right in the side of him.
Continues to attack here. We'll see if he can set up the arm ball.
He's going to attack arm bar here.
Oh, he picks him up and slams him down.
Big explosive slam to lift him and slam him out of that arm bar. Go right into side control. Now let's see what he does, right?
Sometimes when you do that, the choke or the submission can get tighter, but he was able to evade it there.
Yes.
Blades has got an arm. Looks like he's trying to lock up a Kimura. Then he's out. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in these martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
And he's back up again, so the takedowns have been there, as have the get-ups. Left-right combo is good, so 44 total strikes have landed for Curtis Blades.
Straight punch land.
Oh, nice pop there from the crowd as he finally gets the takedown. He stayed committed to the offensive wrestling, and now he has his opponent.
A sigh of relief from the people watching because they were tired of watching him flail around trying to get takedowns and get defended over and over again. Now the guy's got armbar. He's attacking it on him.
Done. I mean, how many can he take? Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter, and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is with his motions on the mat.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up.
He loaded up there on that high kick.
Ooh, big knee. And a knee. Just misses with that big right hand.
Big power punch land. Now he gets back in range.
Well, he has stayed busy and he has stayed accurate. Nice combination.
Very accurate. A lot of activity in the hands. Look phenomenal tonight.
Oh, and there's a takedown attempt, DC. Not a great one. Might as well tell your opponent to shoot, huh?
Yeah, he's your best friend. Tell him that you want to take him to his back and watch him defend and then beat you up in the fight stand.
Tries to mix in a takedown here. Going orthodox now. Round two next. What a round it was for him, DC. And, of course, the seminal moment, that big knockdown that he will try to piggyback on here in this next round.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see.
What a shit round. What a fucking shit shy.
Round two here. And he connects there, DC.
Great job landing that punch.
Trying to inflict some damage here, but misses with the kick. Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't...
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? Oh, he's hurt.
Oh, he might be out.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish the fight. Liver kick.
I can't get that fucking roundhouse kick to work.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick. Another big body kick lands.
And he switches his stance yet again.
He's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Back to the feet. Strong bottom work here. Staying busy.
He's going guillotine.
Yep. Fucking of course. That's what happens. Chaz should go fuck yourself when you're on the ground.
Work from the bottom, tags him with the punch. Lands the grounded pound strike here. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in
fucking
the
glitch
rhythm.
Now.
He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Oh, why is this shit so glitchy?
Big knee lands there.
That knee hurt him.
Knee to the body. Muay Thai plump.
I mean, this guy is really focused on those punches.
I don't even fucking know what position we're in.
Oh, nice knee to the body for him there. Very nice. Pretty good series of knees by him there, DC. He told us on Thursday he felt like they would be there. They have been there.
They have been there, and he is driving them into his opponent's body. It's hard to
watch. What fucking position are we in, cunt?
Those knees aren't just for effect. Those are doing real damage.
Because fucking, it's just a shit show.
Knee to the body.
Big knee lands right through the opponent's midsection.
No.
Oh man, that left side is getting beat up now.
Like, it's slowly making more and more sense, but it's still fucking too slow for this shit. Like, you never had this shit with the other UFC games. Of course it fucks up for this one. Which makes me fucking not want to play this shit.
Strikes in MMA, and he's got that part of his game going tonight.
He has got the knees going. He's throwing them in bunches. Notice the drive. Look at how they drive the knee right into the midsection.
And now he's got that tie clinch. Boy, tie plump.
Wondering if that's a tie clinch or not.
Oh, nice land.
Oh, big knee. Body. Oh, big knee.
He needs to start looking at
What the fuck? He won't even let me block. I got no block.
10 seconds to go.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep.
Fucking he just won fucking that round by grinding me against the fence. Oh, he won the first two rounds.
Right hand punch for the clinch.
Now he's got the Muay Thai plus.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here.
Ooh, head kick lands, he's hurt.
Blades gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Connects now with the 1-2.
Oh, he hurt.
Switching stances here. Immediately gets the underhook.
Right hand punch to the
clinch.
Why won't it let me fucking block, cunt?
What a fight.
Yeah, that right there is a
It won't let me fucking block. What the fuck? What am I meant to fucking do? It wouldn't let me fucking block or anything. Fuck's sake. It's this fucking glitch show I have to fucking deal with. This fucking shithole fucking glitch show I have to fucking deal with. No wonder I can't fucking win any fights. Because I have to deal with this shit. It's not even like you fucking won it decently. Fucking concuss. Fair enough. I'm out for fucking 270 days. Oh, fucking hell. Fuck's sake.